The first people who lived on Iceland are thought to have been Irish monks. They came to Iceland around the year 800. In the 9th century, Norsemen went to live in Iceland. The first Norseman who lived in Iceland was Flóki Vilgerðarson. He was also the one who gave Iceland its name. Ingólfur Arnarson was the first permanent settler on the island. This chieftain from Norway went to live in southwest Iceland and founded the city of Reykjavík. In 930, the Icelandic rulers wrote a constitution. They created the Althing, a kind of parliament in a place called Ingveldir. Therefore, Iceland is the oldest existing republic. In 985, Eric the Red was sent away from the island because he had killed someone. He sailed to the west and discovered Greenland. Eric's son Leif Erikson discovered America in the year 1000. He called it Vinland. The voyages of Eric, Leif, and others were written down in the sagas, long stories. A map of Iceland published in the early 17th century. In 1262, Iceland became part of Norway. This lasted for 400 years. In 1662, it became part of Denmark. In the 19th century, many Icelandics wanted to be independent from Denmark. In 1918, Iceland got many powers of its own, but the King of Denmark was still King of Iceland. When Germany took over Denmark on April 9, 1940, the Althing decided that Icelandics should rule the country themselves, but they did not declare independence yet. British and later American soldiers occupied Iceland to prevent it from being attacked by the Germans. In 1944, Iceland finally became fully independent. After World War II, Iceland became a member of the North Atlantic Treaty Organization, NATO, but not of the European Union. Between 1958 and 1976, there were three debates between Iceland and the United Kingdom about the rights to catch codfish. They were called the Cod Wars. In 1980, Vigdís Finnbogadóttir was elected president of Iceland. She was the first woman ever to be elected president of a country. In 2016, Gunni T. H. Johannesson became president of Iceland.